start the show. We are going to have a game called Three Rules. It's pretty simple. I'm going to need Nathan, Gavin, and Brody out here. This game, they are each going to receive a special rule, and they are going to have to follow that for the whole scene. And in this universe that we'll live in, there's also a universal rule that they're all going to have to follow. So now, for Gavin, can I get an action?
Run it.
Fainting.
Yep, just shout it out.
Dying.
Rollerblading.
Dying.
Murdering.
Lightning
fruit.
Gavin, when you are ignored, you're going to be falling. All right, now for Nathan, can we just get anything, like a noun?
Spinach.
All right, Nathan,
yes.
When anyone looks at you in your eyes, it's going to be as though you're eating spinach. Yeah. All right, now we're going to need like something wrong with Brody, or like a character trait, like.
His shoes are tonight.
Is on time.
I think the audience has spoken. You're going to have lice. So now we need a rule for this universe. Now, give me another action.
Cartwheeling.
Cartwheeling.
All right.
Burpees.
All right.
Don't even do burpees. Don't do it.
Whenever anyone asks a question, you guys are going to start churning some butter. To review.
I fall when people ignore me.
All right.
I have lice.
All right. Awesome. And your universal rule is? All right. Good job. So, can I get a location for this to take place? To go with our show's theme,
Windsor Dining Hall.
I heard doghouse. So your location is doghouse. Take that out.
You might not want to do that.
Hey guys. Thank you. So how long you been here? Response time than that.
Sorry. Well, I've been in here all day. And let me tell you, it's been great.
Just one day? That's crazy, man. What'd you do?
Well, I licked something out of this bowl here. It's pretty wet. And then I kind of walked over there a little bit and came back.
I've been in here. 6 months.
Help me. Why would I help you? Because this guy's not going to. Clearly.
Hey, I'm gonna need some help with something. Pinky promise that you'll do it before I tell you, huh?
I'll help. Just please talk to me more.
Okay. Do you know how to operate toothpicks?
I do. I'm very proficient with toothpicks. It's how I broke out the first three times.
Okay.
You broke out? You broke out. 7 times. I did. You got something in your teeth. Might want to go check a mirror.
I need a toothpick.
It's in the...
Oh, good, I have one. Oh, right here.
Thanks.
No, but you can't... Okay, that's fine. Can you just maybe look at my stack? I think I might have a whole hive. And I know there's a queen in there, so if you could just pull her out, I think they'll stop reproducing. Hold still.
See!
What a great first game. Now, this is going to be followed up with a game called Dating Game. So I need Brody, Karina, Alex, and Carl out here. Bring your chairs. All right, so how this game goes down, if you guys have seen the old game show Dating Game, essentially, this will be our guesser. He's going to guess the identity of these three people. So for him to do that, he has to get out. We gotta wait, he's gonna keep going out.
It would have been easier to take the stairs.
It's all right.
He's
learning.
He's burned some calories. It's good stuff.
All right. So, we are going to need three unique things for him to be able to guess. So, to do this, we're going to need Karina. She is going to be in love with something. What is she in love with? Okay, you're going to be in love with war. All right, so now we need something for Alex. Now, Alex is going to be turning into something. What is he turning into?
Barbie! Barbie!
Blue cheese!
Blue cheese!
I heard Adam Sandler. Yeah. Oh, right. So you're going to be turning into Adam Sandler. And now we just need a person, living or dead, from history or pop culture for Carl to be. Carl, you are going to be our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. All right.
It's just a normal day.
So, to recap, Carino, what are you in love with?
Guns and violence.
All right. Alex.
I'm turning into Adam Sandler.
And Carl.
Jesus Christ.
Awesome! So, now we're gonna have to get our contestant in here, and we're gonna do that with a cry of dating, dating, dating on three. One, two, three.
Dating, dating, dating!
Will.
Dating.
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 All right, fabulous contestant. We are here, gathered here, so that you can find your match made in heaven. So, when you are ready, go ahead and ask the contestants three questions.
Okay. Contestant number one. Hi.
Hi.
So, let me just get right down to it. What is your favorite meal?
Well, I quite like a little bit of steak with some mashed potatoes. It goes really well in my tummy.
Okay, steak and mashed potatoes, kind of that whole country feel. I like it.
I like country.
And you, contestant number two, what is the perfect night out?
Well, I like order and a lot of men. Preferably helmets. And if there's bloodshed, it's a bonus.
Okay.
So move me to the finish.
Aye, aye, sailor. Oh, contestant number three.
Hello, my child.
Contestant number three. Not yet. I mean, I maybe can be anything you want me to be, but not yet. Okay. So tell me, what have your past exes been like?
Well, that's a bit up to the history to decide. She was a wonderful woman. Dad bless her heart. But she was very traditional, as all people should be.
Okay.
You know.
Back to contestant number one. I kind of like some of the nicer things in life. What would be a gift from you to me?
Well, at first, you know, I didn't quite like them, but maybe some golf clubs? I got quite good with golf clubs.
Maybe you can help me with my swing.
Oh, absolutely.
Back to contestant number two. This whole talk of helmets and guys and stuff, where do you work?
Wherever my country needs me. Or wherever there is some freedom to be brought upon.
You are all free.
You're the reason for both of this!
Okay, simmer down. I like a man who can really take charge, though. Contestant number three. Maybe let's talk a little bit more personally. Do you, what's your favorite position? I'll just come out.
I actually prefer bondage. Just tie me up there and leave. I mean, it may take 3 days, but I'll get there.
Honey, one night with me and it'll only take 15 minutes. Okay, so I think I'm ready to make my decision. Contestant number two. You're very charming, but the whole autocracy thing, I just can't do. I'm sorry, Donald Trump. No? I'm sorry, Stalin? How about Hitler?
What are they in love with?
Freedom? Ideology? War? You love war! I'm sorry, I'm a pacifist! Okay, and contestant number one.
Yeah.
You're really boring.
But my movies would say the same thing.
Well, I'm sorry, but I just can't date Ashton Kutcher.
That bozo!
It starts with an A.
Alfred Molina?
It's all in the hips. It's all in the hips.
Honey, I don't know.
It's Adam Sandler! Adam
Sandler! Adam Sandler! Oh my god!
So much for coming.
Oh my god!
And that means that you're going home with?
My Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ! Yeah!
Great round of dating game. All right.
Now we are going to do something that is an ad lib specific. This is called long form. Essentially, it is taking one suggestion, making multiple scenes, trying to incorporate other ideas into them. So to do that, we're going to need just a one word suggestion.
Ocean. Peanut butter.
Basketball.
Mayonnaise.
Word.
Mayonnaise.
All right. I heard this first, so I'm going to go with it. Our suggestion is ocean. Take it how you guys will.
I ran into the sponge the other day.
Derek?
It's the third time this week you ran into the sponge. I know.
You know,
with the laughing and the pineapples and the Krusty Krab and the burgers and the everything.
Yeah, I think you need glasses, honestly.
I'm telling you, it was a talking sponge. It was crazy.
I mean, I'm not surprised, honestly. Sponges talk a lot.
That's insane.
Yeah. You've obviously not met too many sponges.
Nope, just the one. And he's got that friend, too. That annoying, the squid.
Gerald?
Yeah.
Got any threes? Because I'm all in on this.
Go fish. I'll take that. Sucker.
Hit me.
Well, we're not quite alone.
Reginald, where are you?
Well,
6:15.
Just. All right, full house. Oh, God dang it. I had a wild draw 4.
Well, you know what I have? Up my sleeve?
Oh, no.
Blue Eyes White Dragon!
Oh! Dang it!
Oh, my baby!
Dang it!
Reginald!
Oh, fine!
Blue Eyes White Dragon! Reginald!
Just take it all, man. It's not like I needed a cab fare home tonight.
Hey, God. That's a lot of winnings.
Yeah, it is.
You want to put that into good use?
I'm listening.
I think a spot just opened up on my team.
Your team? About yeah. How many people are on this team?
I don't know, like 11? Sometimes 12, but we usually try to keep it around 11.
I'm in.
Aye, it'd be quite windy today, me lad.
Yes, it is, sir!
I need you to go report to port and swab.
Yes, sir! Sorry, sir, move your leg, sir.
Hey, just remove it.
Okay, sorry about that. There, back on, there you go. Thank you, sir.
How's she?
Captain.
Yay?
On the horizon.
What is it? R!
Exactly! It's just a big floating R!
Hook that's clean, sir!
I scrunch the other leg! Where are the other 25 letters?
I'll go find it, sir!
Good. Need more scrubbing! I!
Sir, have we thought about maybe calling in the vowels?
Gentlemen, I'm glad you could come. Please, take a seat. Take a seat.
I'm glad you think of me as a general.
Dang it.
My God.
That's why you're the brute force.
Just. Thanks, man. Just get on with it. What's up?
All right.
We got a big one.
Ooh.
The big one?
The White Whale Casino.
Oh.
It might be our biggest one yet.
My.
Jesus.
Gosh. Hey, all right. Come on, I'm talking here. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to have to get in through the back entrance, all right? Because no one wants to see us in the front entrance. See, people know me, all right?
All right. I think I know a guy. All right. So my ex-boyfriend is like, he kind of hates me, but right now he's on the rebound. So if we get someone to charm him, you can just get in through the back door.
I know a guy.
That's a really great idea. Here. Let's start over. Charm ex-boyfriend.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And what's after that?
Okay.
Step two. Charm ex-boyfriend. Step two. Rename the casino.
Yes.
Like a code name, right? It's what you...
The metaphor.
It's a metaphor. For revenge.
Yeah.
How do you spell that, with an F or a PH?
F, I guess.
Hey, guy. You know that mutation in the last talk?
Yeah.
I think you fared a lot better.
Yeah, I know. Except I gotta listen to your crap all day long.
I don't... Yeah, I'm just trying to live, dude. Derek!
What's up?
I lost the R.
Oh, no! You lost the R!
I don't know where it went. Honestly, I was just looking.
How are we supposed to make the world's biggest alphabet soup if we don't have an R?
Oh, Derek!
All right.
Can I help?
Do you have an R?
No, I don't have an R. I hardly have an I.
It's the mutation. It makes him make really bad puns.
I'm sorry, guy. Okay. That's unfortunate.
It's fine. I'm just going to get out of here. Listen, can we do
okay, do
gymnastics or something like...
This is art.
No, I can't do it. I can't.
All right, Captain.
Yes.
I retrieved one. It's a cue. I figured, you know, it's not used very well, and you know, it's a bit neglected, so it's easy to catch. But it's very close to R, so I think we'll be able to catch it.
Did it come with a U? They're quite close most of the time.
Unfortunately, sir, you couldn't make it.
I'm right here!
No, sir, the letter U.
I didn't ask you!
Sorry, sir, overstepped my bounds.
It's okay, you're learning. Now, swamp my ears.
Yes, sir.
With a cotton swab! Lousy, good-for-nothing crow!
You can't move so much, sir! Please!
So, I have the cue baited, so I feel like if I just chuck it overboard, maybe it'll take the hint and take its rightful place back where it belongs. I'm just gonna do it.
Harpoon off the port! Take wheel, lassie!
God! It's my time! I'll kill the world!
All right, that's enough of that.
Yes, sir!
All right, boys, the big one. One last job and we're out! All right, you, remember the plan. You're gonna go up and you're gonna seduce the ex-boyfriend. All right?
Gotcha.
I'm the model for the ex-boyfriend.
That's true.
All right.
Get this right.
My name is Gary, by the way. His name, Gary. Hey there, cutie.
Hi.
You looking for a good time?
Yes.
That's good, because you can go in the back door anytime you want because I'm a big, stupid whore!
Wait, is this part of the plan? Or...
I'm sorry.
We're professionals, man. I was doing very well, and then you just broke down.
Yeah, on the rebound. It was pretty recent.
Oh, my. You know, I mean, guys, this has to happen tonight.
Wait.
Tonight.
Is there a chance he'll cry?
Him or me? Because I don't
know. Well, okay, why not both? Because if you start crying, this whole thing goes under. I can't go back.
All right. I think I can get control of my emotions.
All right.
One more time.
Let's go.
What's up, sweet cheeks?
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Oh, God.
Sir.
What, bitch? You don't have a patch over your mouth?
We lost it.
I'm sorry, sir! Now, who do I assign blame to? It was her, sir!
Sir, I promise you, I will make this up to you. I already have a harpoon loaded. I feel like if I just shoot it in there, I'll catch another one.
You've disrespected my long line of halves. A-hab, B-hab, and I am the C-hab!
I am so sorry. I swear. It's getting closer, so I'm just going to just go ahead and...
Derek!
He's a fine specimen. What business state ye?
I want my letters back.
Derek, did you find the letters?
I'm asking him for it. Shut up.
Okay, be safe.
Thank you. I love you!
Love you too!
Right. You, hey! You know about the R?
Yes, you could say that.
Okay, great, that's great, that's great. Captain, take over.
I was productive.
Hey, did you give me my leg? Of course, take over.
I don't know what that was, I'm sorry.
Well, son.
Hey, sweet cheeks.
I think that went pretty well. So, now we're going to move on to our next short form game. This is going to be Clockwork. I'm going to need Dan, Karina, Nathan, and John out here. All right, now form your square. All right, so how this game works. There are going to be four scenes happening before you. Each of the scenes is going to have a suggestion that is unique. And if I say left, they're all going to move left into the left scene. And if I say right, they're going to move right. So, for this, we are going to need four suggestions. So we're going to start out with an occupation. So just go ahead and yell it out.
Lawyer, photographer, photographer,
psychiatrist.
All right. I heard photographer. All right, left. Now, for these two, we're going to need a location.
Switzerland.
How?
Mars.
Inside
of
All right, we're gonna go meta, so Windsor Dining Court. All right, to the left. Now we're going to need a relationship for these two, non-familial.
Romance!
Con artist!
All right, I heard sensei.
Oh!
All right, left. Now, for these two, I'm just going to need a noun. So just shout whatever.
Oh, I see the
house. Setting.
I see the house. I see the house.
I see the
house. I see the
house.
Come in the house.
All right. I heard Papa John's Pizza.
Now remember, you can take that how you will.
All right, so left. What is your guys' suggestion?
Photographer.
Yeah, photographer.
All right, left.
Windsor Dining Court.
Sensei.
Sensei. Just yep.
Yeah. Left.
Papa John's Pizza.
All right, so we're going to start out with right.
Hun, you're a little bit under balance. You got any dying dog? Okay.
I'm gonna go eat now.
What?
Excuse me, sir.
What?
Sir.
What?
I noticed that your shoes are actually non-vegan leather, so... I'm going to have to ask you to take those off and leave them here with all the longboards.
Hey, sorry.
Right.
Bad news, Jimmy. I know your job at the newspaper. You've cherished it so much, we might have to let you go.
Carl! You can't do that to me! I want to free you!
Now, Jimmy,
son, I have tenure!
Son, I understand this is a frustrating time for you, so I'm gonna have to put up the chart.
No, not the chart!
The chart!
No!
It's coming!
No, not
the chart! Boom! You see this?
No!
I'm also gonna get the stick. The stick!
No!
Right.
Sir, did you order the deluxe sausage?
I mean, I did, but I'm not sure if I still want to.
It has extra meat!
Are you okay?
My wife loved me. Sensei, please! Teach me the art of making a spaghetti casserole.
Oh, this is so simple. Okay, get up.
Thank
so
you, Chef
mama. Da-da-da-da-da. You zip it a little bit, and we get it over there.
Of course.
Ledo.
Ledo!
Keres, Ledo. No, get us it!
I'm sorry, I get ahead of myself.
Now you roll. You rolling?
I'm rolling.
Like you touch a fine woman, you're like,
Then you're going for the kiss, right?
No!
Okay.
Yeah, I didn't mean to strike a nerve there, man.
No, dude, it's fine. It's whatever, though.
Hey, I'll make it up to you. You look like you could use a night in.
No, I probably need to go have a night out at the bars, you know?
Hey, man, it's cool. I got just the tip. And...
that was pretty good. You're not bad.
Get out of my sight.
Left.
Yeah. Money. You see this right here?
Yeah.
This is a dollar bill taped to my chart.
Yeah.
And it is showing this is all the revenue we've made in the last 3 years. All right?
It's not my fault you guys can't earn a newspaper.
What? I'm not sure if you realize newspapers don't make any money anymore. So
they made that dollar. My salary's half of that.
I know, Jimmy. But you gotta consider, one picture is worth 1,000 words, both in terms of context and in terms of file space. So, the way that we see it, we can save a lot of data by just going text only, and it covers just as much, if not more, space. So
you don't need me to take pictures anymore, that's what you're telling me?
Yes, and... I need the camera to sell back.
I don't know what camera you're talking about.
Well,
Oh. I don't have it on me. Did we give you the camera phone as part of the upgrade 2 years ago?
Left.
All right, now recite after me. Meat is murder.
Meat is pretty good.
Again.
Meat is delicious.
Were your pamphlets? Page 3. You remember that piglet?
You mean Wilbur?
Yeah. May you recite that one more time?
Meat is...
We tossed the pie, correct? Oh, my God.
No,
I'm sorry.
I'm
sorry.
You don't toss the pie yet? We make a spaghetti calzone. What do you think I'm doing?
I was thinking of pizza.
Nut! You got your boiling water?
Okay, get the water.
You'd make your little finger dance over it. It don't do much, but I like it.
Okay.
Okay, you see the noodles?
Yeah.
Now with your bare hands, you grab the noodles.
I have human hands.
You grab the noodles, and like machine claw.
Okay, you got like 9 steps in
just
there.
Like that.
Hello?
Hey, pizza guy. I'm so sorry about last week with the wife. I decided that I'm going to give you a coupon for one free plumbing service because I want to lay some pipe.
Well, on that, whoa. Thank you. So on that groaner, we are going to move on to our next game. And as you know, all of you who donated, thank you so much. You're going to get drawn up here, hopefully, for a chance to be sang to by these magical men. So, I need a chair out here.
Chair.
I got it.
Oh.
Back off.
Sorry. All right, thank you. And the grand prize winner is, if I can open this, there we go, Lauren Dickerson. So I hope that's a real person. Right. If you could have a scene up here. Thank you so much for coming up here. I hope you're enjoying the show.
Yes, definitely.
All right, so, Lauren.
Yes.
What is your best childhood memory?
Oh boy, you've really put me on the spot here. Well, let's see. I loved spending time with my great-grandparents.
Oh, that's so sweet. What were their names?
Yulita and Darold.
Yulita, that's quite an interesting name.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, okay. So what would you do with your grandparents that you enjoyed so much?
Well, for spending time with my grandmother, we would cook, bake cookies. And my grandfather, we would, and this is going to sound kind of strange to many people, we would put down the garage door and we would... my sister and I would ride our bikes around the garage while he sat out and smoked and watched us.
He sounds like a really awesome guy.
Oh, absolutely.
So just another random question I don't have written on this cue card or anything. If you won the lottery, what would you do with it? Question we ask everyone.
Okay, first and foremost, we'd get the heck out of Indiana.
Oh.
course, be responsible parents, save up with kids' college funds, make sure that we had enough money to retire.
Yeah.
All right, so now we are going to have the talented singing group Love Machine come out here to sing Lauren a ballad.
Daryl and Yulita were feeling muy bonita, and that's where we found you. Don't feel like a loser because you're a Hoosier, Indiana. We love you.
But Lauren, I will take you far away from this place you so do hate and make you feel special.
To leave Indiana, but without you, I'd be nada.
Lauren,
Lauren, please don't leave.
Don't leave us.
Seriously, we're so lonely.
God, you're the best.
Lauren,
Lauren,
Lauren.
I want those cookies that you baked with your grandma.
I want to go on that bike race with the cigarettes.
Run in circles with you.
Lauren. I hope you liked your song.
It was beautiful.
All right, let's all thank Lauren. All right, cool. So, it has come to be that time. It is our second long form. So, as with the first, I'm just going to need a one-word suggestion. We'll take it from here.
Yes.
Potatoes.
All right. So, the suggestion is telepathy. Take it how you guys will.
Woo, go John!
John!
My God, you're here! Ah,
yes.
I sensed it.
As you should.
Master.
The 8-ball told me no.
I'll do it anyways. All right, I'm glad you came. Now, first you have to pay me. And then I tell you your future itself.
I'm nervous, honey. I don't know if we should... This is kind of scary.
I'm terrified too, but...
I want to know! Oh!
What do you see? I see a hand.
You, him.
Oh.
Your grandfather. He died in the war, didn't he?
I mean, you could call it a war.
Ah, divorce strikes many families. I see it in your future.
All right, yeah, I see it too.
Hold up, gotta finish this cig.
Okay.
All right. Oh!
What'd you see?
You're a Sagittarius, aren't you?
I don't know!
Trust me! Okay. You are!
All right.
I see a very strong and robust individual. Oh my!
You look like the same guy?
Yes, he is strong. Just like the centaur that once roamed the Greek lands. Here, take these chicken bones.
What do I do with them?
I don't even drop them.
Oh, don't drop them.
Ah!
Quickly. No. They've already been touched.
Ah!
You take them down. Oh, 70 years of your children. 70 years. Out of that uterus.
That happens anyway.
John?
Yeah?
Jacob Jingleheimer Schmidt, I presume?
Of course.
I'm sure you're wondering why I'm here to talk to you today. Well, it's like this. You ever get a sixth sense that, like, makes you feel a little weird about something?
Oh, I went through puberty at your age, too.
But, like, I was sitting in the middle of my test, and just some started acting up. I don't know how to say it. Professor was cheating!
Your professor was cheating?
Yeah. Walking over to each and every student, giving them the right answers.
Oh. But not you, I presume?
No! It's not fair!
I think I might have a theory as to why that is.
Because my professor hates my loud voice!
No, that can't be it.
You're my dad! You know that I never had an inside voice! Ever since I was born, straight out the womb! Wah! Wah!
Yes, we have the video right here to play.
Let's see it. Wah! Wah! Yeah, see? Just like that!
Yes, son. Maybe we could put you in voice therapy, maybe? Or you could just talk quieter. It's not really that hard.
I don't know how you never taught me!
Times like these, fathers are tested. You know I love you, and you know, Mom didn't leave because she couldn't sleep. She'll be back. Don't worry, son.
It's so hard! Every night, I think about it.
Yeah, we hear you in your night terrors. You see, I've been dating another woman. She's deaf. It'll be perfect.
All right, kiddos. Gather around. Hand. Is this your card?
No.
How about
this?
Oh my God. My mama told me about you.
What did she say?
She says that the Lord has banished you to the Badland.
Deal smear! I practiced my safe magic! It's all cards and fake real wands! You believe me, don't you?
Of course.
I sense doubt in your eyes.
She does not. I just have good eyes.
Explain this! I put holy water in it, caught the flame!
That's a pretty cool magic trick.
That seems like second level.
Another one.
Thank you.
Man, it's rough out there for us, isn't it?
Tell me about it. The crowds, they are all kids. Only kid shows.
I had this couple the other day. Poor sons of guns. They came in, threw down $100. I was like, oh, yeah, chicken bones, eight ball, and all that stuff. It was terrible. Absolutely terrible.
Best thing I've ever heard.
You're welcome. My God!
I'm a cancer. I just learned that. I looked it up on the internet.
That's what I said! Cancer!
I just spoke to a doctor.
It's between Cancer and Sagittarius.
Oh, I didn't know that existed. I'm so sorry.
That's all right. Many people come to me and they're like, I didn't know, but I do, because I'm, you know. I mean, he looks credible.
Unlike that guy.
Come on, look at this guy.
What? Here. What do you do for a living? What do you do for a living, bud?
Well, I trick parents into letting me do these cool little, like, magic. And then I show it to them, and I think...
He disappeared!
He's so good!
Son, get in here!
Really?
Yeah!
Do I have to?
Son, get in here!
You're always like this! What? What do you want, Dad?
Son!
Yes!
I had my eardrums removed. We can be a family again!
Oh my God! Come on in, you big lug!
Who's this stranger in my house?
Meet my speech therapist!
Oh. Hi. How you doing?
That's... Oh my God, you're you and her! Why didn't you tell me, Dad?
Son, I forgot to learn to read lips.
Do I have to write this down in all capital letters?
Hi, son.
Why didn't you tell me you were with my dad?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't quite catch that. Well, you see, your father and I... That's you, yeah, yeah. Yeah, you, yeah. Yeah. You see, your father and I...
Yeah?
We've been seeing each other for quite a while now.
You did it!
I didn't know.
My mom!
What? Yes, your mother.
She was in it too?
Yeah.
Oh my God!
Yeah, man, so I got out of there.
I knew you were. I could sense you coming down Broadway. What can I do for you?
I'd actually like my fortune told today.
Ah, fantastic. Another lonely soul walking this whole universe. I love it.
You know what? I'll one-up you. I'll give you your fortune today. You're going to prison for a long time for fraudulent claims.
But!
Like, there's no way this is in any way legal.
Prison! My God!
Undercover FBI.
You didn't see that coming.
Bell! Take out the retirement fund! Take everything! No! We're going to Columbia!
She's speaking magic words!
Get him! Oh, God! Don't ever take me alive! Don't ever take me alive! I've got magic powers! You're all gonna die in hell!
I am a Sagittarius Ranianius.
That went pretty good. All right. So for our next short form game, we are going to play a game called Arms Expert. For this, one person is going to be the expert. They are not going to have arms, but they are going to be provided. You two, yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Example.
I have arms.
This will be our lovely host, and he will be asking you questions to ask the expert. So, we're going to need what John is an expert in. So just go ahead and tell him. I don't think I've heard from this.
Taxidermy!
going to be an ice cream expert, so like an expert in driving an ice cream truck. So take that how you will. You'll be getting the question. And go on.
Welcome to the Holly Jolly Swirly Whirly channel with our host, the expert Mr.
Cool Guy.
Mr. Cool Guy. We're going to be asking some questions if you have some problems with your ice cream and ice cream related needs. Now I need some hands in the audience. Yes, you, sir.
Hi.
Hi. Do you have a question for our expert, Mr. Cool Guy?
Yeah. Where does Rocky Road come from?
That's a big one, I'm going to be honest. Well, I mean, in 1842, France conquered China. They said, you know what, there's a lot of rocks here. We could probably build a couple roads out of this stuff. And they threw that together with some ice, and bam, there you go. Just scrambled it all up and got yourself a milkshake. There you go, you got a rocky road there, big boy. Drank that up, and the French milk.
Wow, I think I've read that once. We need some more question participation. You, sir.
How do I get the perfect swirl on my ice cream cone?
That's easy. You grab the ice cream with your hands. Grab the cone, slam those bad boys together. Then you just pound it, beat it in a little bit. Grab another one, pound it in there again, put it on top. There you go. Now it's nice and beat down. You gently massage the ice cream for a couple hours until it's nice and soft. And then you put it back in the freezer. Grab another once it's done for a couple hours, put it back in the cone. And then you just caress it with your hand right there into the swirl. Perfect. Every time.
Sweet. You in the back, yes.
Since you're an ice cream expert, what do you think is better, the three classic flavors or all the new ones?
Okay, that's this is very opinionated, so I may get a little heated, gonna be real. You're gonna need a cool down, it's something, like that's for sure. But the three original flavors, you can only get the new flavors with the original flavors. So you have to get the original. And none of this knockoff, like, remastered stuff. Like, you only get the original stuff, okay? You get vanilla, you get chocolate, and you get boysenberry. Those three, you mix them up, and you can get any new flavor. It's BS, all this. Oh, look, we're going to throw in some random ice cream crystal. That's a lie. There's only three flavors, and that's all it will be.
Token. Any more? You in the back, yeah.
What are your thoughts
on Froyo? That's why I like to call my big boy gun. I only use it when I get really mad. And that was a trigger word. No pun intended, my man. But Froyo is a joke, it's an abomination to God. I will not stand for some vegan lie coming into my town and stealing my ice cream. Don't ever come in here, dude, like it's mine, okay? Just leave it alone. Well, I think we have time for one more. How about you in the front, yeah.
Is Sherbert okay?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you, this has been Mr. Cool Guy. I'm glad you tuned in.
It's just so sad that our night has to come to an end, so we're going to play our last game out here. It's actually called Freeze. Everybody get out of here.
I think it's called Irony, by the way.
Yeah, okay. I don't know. Anyway, so Freeze is essentially what's going to happen is two people are going to be doing a scene at any point they can call.
Freeze!
Freeze.
And that means that they're going to have to come on and take whatever position the person was in before. All right, so two people want to start?
Okay.
All right, cool. And we're just going to need a location.
Spain.
Poland.
Russia.
In the refrigerator.
Russia.
Poland.
Russia.
In the refrigerator.
I think I heard bathtub at some point. I really like bathtubs, so we're gonna go with bathtub.
Okay, Jimmy. Ready for your bath?
Yeah!
Yeah, yeah. That's what I thought. Here's your soap.
Ah! Ah!
And...
Ah! I can't
Jimmy!
See!
Jimmy, man up! Man up, Jimmy! Be a man!
Put it in my eyes!
This is so tricky.
I want to hug you, but I know I can't.
You did so many bicep curls. You're too big.
What is he such a...
How's my painting going?
Very well, I'm just inspecting the back.
Oh, yes. You'll find my mole right next to my right rib. You gotta guess which one, though. One, two, three, four, five.
You have a lot of moles. You might want to go to a dermatologist.
Like, your back is just all moles.
I can't see my back. I need a mirror. I still can't see my back. Help me. Okay, help me. You have to do something.
Listen here, you no good scum.
You're gonna pay me the $30 that you owe me for that cheese, okay?
Okay,
This material is incredible. What's in there?
You know, just finest sheep cashmere.
Whoa! You mean you had to kill a sheep to get that?
Of course, that's how you get cashmere, right?
I don't know.
Well, if not that...
You're a monster! You kill animals!
Hey.
Oh.
Hey!
Oh!
Hey! All right, we need to quit this. We have to do surgery.
Hey!
And so my iron moves 5 spaces, and now I'm beating you. Because your car is clearly further behind than my iron.
Well, you know what I got? Get out of jail free card.
I hope you really like this movie.
I mean, I'm looking at the reviews on Rotten Tomatoes right now.
Oh yeah, well this...
Yeah, it's like, as long as it's like above 30, that's usually pretty good.
Let me out of this place! He's crazy!
Oh, wow, you calmed down.
All I said was I prefer episode 5 over episode 4.
Please, God!
Thank you guys so much for coming out. It's been so fun. Thank you for helping this tremendous cause and petting all the cute dogs. And we are at Liberation. Do you guys want to do a roll call? Let's go ahead.
I'm John.
Brody.
Karina.
By the way.
Carl.
Nathan.
Dan.
Gavin.
And we are at Liberation. Good night.